Now, teleportation as a means of transport is something that has captivated humans for quite some time. The ability to just pop in and out of existence in different places is something that would undoubtedly be incredibly convenient in everyday life, but most likely something that we won't be achieving anywhere in the foreseeable future. There is, however, a creature in the world of Subnautica which not only has the ability to transport itself via teleportation at will, but can also grab other creatures and move them around the place like it's no big deal at all. That creature will be the topic of this video today, being the Warper, of course, or also known as the Self-Warping Quarantine Enforcer Unit, as named by the Precursors. I will tell you everything we know about this creature, what it looks like, where you can find them, and maybe some other parts of interesting trivia that you may or may not have known before. As with all of the other lore videos I have made, I also need to warn you that there will be spoilers to the story of Subnautica, so if you haven't had the chance to experience it for yourself yet, and you would like to, I strongly recommend clicking off the video now and coming back later. Anyways, with that out of the way, jump into your Seamoth, but don't get too comfortable because you're probably gonna be teleported out anyways, and let's go. Now first of all, even though I called it a creature, the Warper is fairly far detached from every other piece of fauna that you can find in the world of Subnautica. In itself, it is actually a biomechanical lifeform that was purely constructed by the Precursors as a combination of many different lifeforms from other worlds, with the main purpose of seeking and destroying the Carabacterium and protecting the bases the Precursors had built. Looking at them from the outside, they have a round and flat head with two small sacs that are visible from the sides. In its mouth, they have a pair of mandibles on either side and two large teeth in the center, which are surrounded by four small eyes with a distinct bioluminescent glow, which can make them fairly eerie if you see them in the darkness. The rest of their body is mostly covered with a thick purple coat-like skin, which overlays the more translucent turquoise part of their body, which contains a lot of the machinery built into them. The lower section of the Warper consists of six separate tentacles, however only the true translucent ones are ever used for propulsion, and it has two scythe-like arms, which are both finished off with a translucent spike. Now, in terms of behavior, at the very basic level, a Warper will patrol a small area around the point where it spawned, warping around to the beginning every so often and attempting to kill either the player if they're infected by the Caravirus or any other species that are in the area which have the infection within them. For all other situations, the Warper will only observe but will not directly engage with anything present in the area. Once it has detected something infected, it will shoot a teleportation orb, for the lack of a better word, towards said creature and will begin its assault. When it gets close to its target, it will emit a loud cry and then attack it with its spiked arms, dealing 65 damage to the player and anything else in its path. They're also capable of shooting projectiles, which will deal 5 damage per hit, and perhaps the most impressively, they are capable of warping aggressive fauna, depending on the region and biome that you're in, into the area to fight whatever they're fighting. The number of things that they're able to teleport depends on the size of the creature. With something very small, like a bleeder for example, the number can be as high as 7, but with something really large, like a crab squid for example, there can only be 1 at a time. These teleported creatures will stay in for a short amount of time before another portal opens and they disappear back to their original spot, and if they attempt to do this in an area where there is no hostile life form nearby, the portal will simply close on its own without spawning anything. To add on top of that, if the player is located inside the Seamoth or the Prawn Suit, the Warper can actually teleport them out of it, leaving them very vulnerable to any hostile creatures or even the Warper itself. However, this can be circumvented by being inside of the Cyclops, as the Warper is unable to teleport you out of that one. Now, as I already mentioned, these creatures are not always hostile to the player because it strongly depends on the area and on the stage of the infection that the player is in. In terms of where you can find them, the biomes can vary quite a bit, from the Bloodkelp Zone to dunes to the Grand Reef, all the way to the Lost River, but in general, they will mostly congregate around alien bases or places with depth greater than 300 meters. But what exactly are they? I mean, we've already mentioned that they're not animals and they were manually created by the precursors, but from what the PDA gives us, we can actually learn more information. Apparently, only a very small amount of their genome is taken from the local life forms, with everything else being a combination of dozens of different off-world animals in combination with some precursor technology. For example, their digestive and pulmonary systems being replaced with a battery, a miniature face system implemented beneath the skin to allow for an instantaneous teleportation to occur, several augments to their brain and central nervous system, as well as a remote communication system which allows these things to communicate with one another and relay information. Now, originally, these were constructed in the disease research facility that the player can find on the planet. However, that construction has been halted after the attack of the sea dragon Leviathan, and after the subsequent and supposed demise of the precursors, these things have simply continued to wander the planet, trying to wipe out the carbacterium and protecting the bases built by their original masters. Interestingly enough, a lot of the hostile fauna of the planet will be also very hostile to the Warper, which has been theorized by people is due to the fact that the Warpers have been wiping out infected members of their species for a long time. The player can actually happen to intercept some communication going on between the Warpers via the radio in their base. Showing that these things are intelligent enough to maintain logical communication with each other, and also the fact that Riley Robinson, the main protagonist of the game, is the one target that is unaccounted for by the species. Now, I think that many players have probably decided to change the course of their travels upon hearing this sound. However, even if you do, this does not have to be the end of it, as there are some consistent ways in which you can deal with Warpers, even if you get to the point of being teleported out of your vehicle. First of all, as already mentioned, if you have a faster means of transport, such as for example the Sea Glide, you can dodge the teleportation globes that they shoot at you, and if you use something like the Stasis Rifle, for example, you can incapacitate them pretty easily to the point where they will be unable to move for a few seconds before simply teleporting away. Now, just to end this video off, a few interesting facts and theories that maybe we could potentially go into. Firstly, it seems rather likely that the three survivors of the Degassi may have encountered some Warpers, as Bart himself has confirmed that Paul, Marguerite and himself were infected, even though this encounter would never have been documented by them. In another point, even though they are classified as a carnivore by the PDA, they in fact have no digestive system and therefore supposedly do not eat at all, which could also work with the fact that they have a rather similar general shape to the Sea Emperor Leviathan, specifically with their scythe-like limbs and the mandibles on their head. However, it has been stated by the art director, Corey Stratter, that their similarities are unintended and that they were not modeled after each other. And finally, if you thought the Warpers are bad now, at some point they were much worse, as they were considerably faster and the damage of their projectiles has varied anywhere from 5 all the way up to a whopping 90 damage on hit. So hey, maybe encountering them now is not quite as bad as it could potentially be. But anyways, with that, I'm going to end this video. I hope you guys found it interesting and maybe learned something new about the species of Warpers in the world of Subnautica. If there are any points that I missed or any interesting theories that you would like to go into, please make sure to leave them down in the comments below, as I'm sure that other people looking into this subject would also be interested to read them. If you enjoyed the video, maybe consider leaving a like, commenting or subscribing. All of those would be very much appreciated. I want to wish you a beautiful rest of the day. Thank you for all of the support that's been going on the channel. It's absolutely insane. And I'm going to see you in whatever next video I make. Bye bye.